This brings us to driving on the freeway. When entering the freeway, begin accelerating before you get to the on-ramp. As you enter the on-ramp, use your turn signal to let the others know your intention to merge. Even if others aren't on the freeway, using your signal will help make your turn signal use a habit. Now you want to make sure that your speed matches that of the traffic already on the freeway. You should be up to their speed by the end of the on-ramp. When merging with traffic, don't wait until the last second to pick a spot. Find yourself a spot before you get there. Remember, it is the responsibility of the driver getting onto the freeway to get up to the speed and merge properly, not the other way around. Keep pace with the flow of traffic in your lane. Don't attempt a lane change into faster moving lanes of traffic until you can keep pace with traffic in that lane. Now, if you're already on the freeway and in the right-hand lane, just remember that consideration and safety are the fundamental keys here. So if the traffic permits and you're not exiting anytime soon, say the next half mile, move over one lane to the left. Try to make their merging experience a nice one. But if you can't move over a lane to your left, try not to reduce your speed when another car is entering the freeway, unless that's the only thing you can do to avoid a collision. When you have cars behind you, slowing down for one car entering the freeway is not the appropriate action to take. The point of this exercise is to not create a situation that requires everyone behind you to have to apply their brakes. Remember, keeping up your momentum as well as the momentum of others can help reduce the nation's gas consumption. And you guessed it, gridlock. So from time to time, it may be necessary to increase your speed to allow entering cars to merge smoothly.